my next video, I'd like to do one on how to remove certain parts of a photo and the difference between removing them, having it filled in like it wasn't there, and then actually deleting it or erasing it. So there's two different ways that we can do this. So first off, to preface, I'm on my Samsung S25 Ultra. I'm using One UI 8 Beta 7. I believe this works on the S24, 23. It looks a little different. In fact, just with the newest Beta 7 that came out, they added a different kind of feature here that I'll go over and show you. But it's all the same principles and all the same way that it works. So first thing you want to do is you want to get a picture. I just got a plain old sunflower for the demonstration here. So you want to make sure it's in your gallery. And then the first thing you can do is, like I said, there's two ways to do this, but it also yields two different results. So the first thing we can do is let's go with the AI, the stars in the very middle of the on the bottom. We'll tap that. And now it says tap or draw around anything, and it just turned off that you want to have erased. So let's go ahead and just let's pick a petal. We'll tap around that. It'll then select it. Now I have a couple options. I can move it, I can rotate it, but see, if I move it, see what happens? It leaves the blank. It doesn't remove it and then fill it in like my next example that I'm going to show you does. You can hit the pen, tap areas where removed to bring them back. So there's all kinds of ways with the, this is called generative edit. So let's just do it again so I can go over. So you highlight what you want, it'll automatically snap to it. Then we can erase it, bring it back. This is an option to rotate it, make it bigger. I can take this, delete it, and then load in with the three icons. So I can load add from gallery, and you can put photos on top of photos. So, you know, example, you have a photo and you want to add something to it. This is how you would do it. Okay. So there's my example on how to do a generative edit. So the next one is the one that most people are going to use. And I'm just going back here to get back to the main page here. I don't know if this will work this way or going. Okay, I have to go back that way. So next what we have is, say I want to remove an actual petal, then have it filled in. Or, you know, you can remove certain artifacts, items in a picture that you don't want there. It, on this option, will fill in the background, also using artificial intelligence, AI. But it does a really, really amazing job. So let's go ahead and I'll show you how you do this one. So the pen is the one we're interested in, the second from the left. So go ahead and tap that. And then what we're going to do is we're just going to go to these four little dots all the way to the right. Okay, so I had to actually redo this. So I was close. I made a mistake though, so I'm just backtracking a little bit here and erase some things in the video that didn't need to be. So we are on the right track. So you want to hit the four buttons, then you want to hit object eraser. Okay, and now tap draw around anything you want to erase. So I don't select any of this. You can do a magnetic lasso. I'll turn that on so it'll automatically go around the object without me having to do it precisely. So say we're going to erase this petal. Okay, now it snaps to it. But you see the background looks like it's gonna delete it, and that's what threw me. So you just tap erase, and it actually erased it. not only erased it, but it put in the row that it thought was behind it. So if we want to do it again, let's do another one. Let's do this one. And it should make a black and white or a black background. So it actually sensed, that's how intelligent this is. It sensed there were two layers. I took off the first petal. You would think, okay, yeah, it would take the first petal out and make a black background, but it didn't. It filled in, and I'm going to back it up. It filled in that. So it actually filled in the second background petal. Then when I did it the second time, it actually went to the background then. So that, like I said, that's how intelligent it is. So it's really pretty sharp. So again, this is different from erasing the item and then having checker marks. This actually erases it and fills it in with what it thinks should be there. So that's what I wanted to show, and I kept going to the wrong section, but that's how we do it. So I hope you found my video to be helpful. Thank you for being here. Please click like and subscribe to my channel. Leave me a comment down below. Thank you for your time, and until next time, I'm out.